Hello, everybody. Hold on. Let me get on this side of the camera. Me, myself, and I, cameraman, you know what I mean. I'm going to move this up just a little bit so I'm looking into the lens. I got me a cup of coffee, by gum. I'm ready to do a video here. I've been watching videos for the last few days and seen some real good ones on the explanation that Mr. Baldwin gave on how the firearm went off. But I'm also taking into consideration that there's quite a bit of stress knowing that the firearm you're holding went off, was responsible for the death of a person and the injuring of another. That can play into what he has going through his mind. So, I'm going to give him some benefit of a doubt because I do not know the firearm that he had in his hand. I do not know if it was tampered with. I do not know if some of the notches in the hammer mechanism were removed by an unexperienced gunsmith. But what I can do is show you some things with different type firearms that I have in my possession. Let's start with one that we know he wasn't using, and that is the black powder Remington style frame. This one here is a brass frame, so it's not exactly the Remington. I've forgotten what the Confederate version was, but this is a replica of the Confederate version. But this one here has three clicks. There's one, there's two, okay, let's try that again. One, two, three. Okay, the second one here, it will go forward somewhat. Third one, the only way to release that hammer is to pull the trigger. This is a single action. You don't want to drop the hammer from here because it messes up the mechanism inside the gun. You want to take care of your firearms. Even if it is a stage gun, you want to take good care of it because it's not your property. My dad always said, take good care of your tools, they'll take good care of you. And if you borrow a tool, make sure to return it in just as good a condition, if not cleaner, than when you borrowed it. Black powder, if it don't have the caps on the nipples here, you're not going to get any fire to any powder in the chamber. But I am going to do something here so you can tell that this is an unloaded cylinder. Because we definitely want you to know that I'm not going to be pointing a loaded gun in your direction. John Snyder was pointing out that you want to check out that the barrel itself is not got any obstructions in here that may fly out when you touch off a blank. with no cylinder in there now. The hammer is in the half-cock position. I am not touching that trigger. I'm going to look down the barrel and see that there is no obstruction in that barrel. Now to put this one back together again, you got to rock that cylinder in there. Oh, come on now. This has always been a cantankerous revolver for me. Oh, come on. There we go. It's not in there. There it is. There it goes. It went in straight this time. Yes, you have to be very mindful of what your firearm does. Now, half cock, or come on, half cock. That runs like that. That's a black powder revolver. He was not using one of those. Those are fun to use though. He was using a 45 caliber, and his was a Colt. This here is a Uberti reproduction of a Colt. It don't have the four clicks like an actual Colt. It has the three. There's the first click. Second click and third click. You have to press down on the trigger and have your thumb on that hammer, otherwise it's going from the full cock position, it will fly forward. But from what he was saying, he eased the hammer back, Is that good? Can you see that? And they were doing their positioning of the firearm. And you go back far enough, you get into that first click. That first click is your click where you can load your ammunition in. You have to be very purposeful about that. You can tell that sucker's not loaded. You have to be purposeful. Get my tongue untied here. This here is a snap cap, not a real bullet. But it does have a primer-like end to it that the firing pin hits up against. You load one end. Okay, I got five here. I thought I grabbed all six, so I'm going to skip one, load that, and then load four, you know. That's what your old cowboy load would be. So you'd be sitting on an empty cylinder for safety. Okay, I clicked one too many times. Did it again, but I'm going to unload this. The basic gist of it there. Okay, that's unloaded. But to get that hammer to go forward, even on this, you have to pull the trigger. Now, that's the third click, and it still won't go all the way forward, and it locks that cylinder up. The fourth click, I should say, that final click, you're ready to launch a bullet downrange. That's the 45. Well, what if it wasn't that? What if it was another revolver? That's a U-Birdie. This here is a Taylor's Company, and it is also a U-Birdie, but the Taylor's Company goes through and fine-tunes them. This one here is in 38. I will show you as well. This one has four clicks. That this one is unloaded as well. This has the four clicks like an actual Colt. So this, if you'd have had something like this, I'm going to get my finger out of that trigger. He said he was pulling back. It's not going to fly forward from that position because the first notch caught that hammer. How about the second notch? Pulling back. Cylinder's moving. Click. That's your notch you'd load from. Well, it won't fly forward from there. Pull back. Third click, the hammer goes forward. As you can tell, this revolver does not have the firing pin on the hammer. It has it in the frame. Well, how about we pull it full? There's your full cock. Huh. You have to put your finger on that trigger, and this one has a nice trigger on it. I barely touched that, and that hammer went forward. He could have had a fine-tuned trigger on that revolver. He could have barely touched that sucker. That could have been it. Because sometimes if you've overtuned a trigger, you barely touch that sucker. Some people would say breathe on that, and that hammer would be released. I bought this from the store. I have not done any work to this or had any work done to it, other than what came from the company. So, there's three different types of single action revolvers. I do not have a Smith & Wesson variant that they had back then. That was the Schofield. I don't have one of those. They were a good revolver, and you had to purposely pull the hammer back on them and also use the trigger to release the hammer from the final stage. So, what I'm going to ask my viewers and the people that have watched this video, to keep all parties in your prayers, because I know that they are going through a lot of stress and a lot of anxiety. They will need counseling from their clergy. They will need counseling from medical people. they will need people to say, okay, we're here for you to talk to, we're here to help you through these hard times. And it's not going to be once or twice. They're going to go through a lifetime of this. Each time they close their eyes, they're going to relive that moment. Each time they see a revolver, they're going to relive that moment. But what they need to do, what Mr. Baldwin needs to do, is to get up off the ground, dust himself off, seek a professional teacher, someone who can teach him step by step firearms safety, step by step firearms use, and not be so anti-gun about things, but open up his mind and say, hey, if I'm going to get bucked off this horse, I'm going to get back up on that horse and I'm going to ride. Because once you've had an accident, you've got to face your ghosts. Otherwise, it's going to haunt you each and every day. And you're going to go, what if I'd have done this? What if I'd have sought professional training prior to all of this? And to the gun person on the set, I'm going to suggest to get more training. They may have all the training in the world, but it never hurts to get trained more. And always check your ammunition. To any movie group making a movie with any type of firearms, don't get lax on your protocols. If you have to, get a military weapons expert on the set. I don't care if you have to get a Marine drill sergeant, I should say gunnery sergeant, who's not afraid to let you have it, both barrels, verbally, if you make a mistake. Sort of like Gunny, but too bad Gunny's gone. But get somebody on there that's going to catch your mistakes and go, you need to think this through. Anyway, keep them all in your prayers. That's what I'm asking. Thank you for watching my take on this mess. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.